out of my pot head. Decorative pots, that is. Oh, shoot. So it's going to create a well-traveled home, even if you... Oh, my gosh. Excuse me. I can't. Everybody, my name is Andrea. If you're new here, and if you are, feel free to hit that subscribe button down below. And to my OG subscribers, thanks for tuning back in and welcome back to another video. This video is gonna be short and sweet, but so good. So, I have come to the realization that I'm a pothead. Decorative pots, that is. Fun fact, I've never had alcohol or any type of drug ever in life. Like ever. And a lot of people think that's weird, but I don't. That's just my choice. Everyone has a thing that just does it for them. For me, it's fashion, home decor, and Chick-fil-A. Yeah, Chick-fil-A's up there. Now, I have been in home goods heavy lately. Like, at this point, we go together.
We go together now?
Real bad.
But the reason I've been shopping so heavy is because when this time around hits, that Halloween, fall, Christmas time, the stores are flooded with that seasonal decor and there's very little like normal stuff to look at. So I've been getting what I'm getting is good, okay? I found the most amazing pots, vases, vessels, all that, whatever you want to call it, in Home Goods, and I just had to share them with you guys. Now, vessels are a super duper easy way to elevate a space, to restyle it, refresh it. So it's very inexpensive relative to buying a whole new couch or buying a whole new bed or just any other furniture piece. Like, they can be very inexpensive. So here is the first one, and I am in love with it. It was, this is only $39.99. It's giving kind of brutalist, a little wobby, and I just love the color payoff on it. It gives off that rustic and rough look, but it's also soft and feminine because of the shades in it. I was thinking about maybe, bringing this color down so it can be a little bit more uniform, but I may just keep it like this. I don't know. I'll have to see when I put it up in the space that I am planning to put it in, but I just love it so much. Like I said, I've been really into vessels and pots just because they're so easy to swap out. Like if you want a new look in a room, just swap out your decor. And I've also been, you know, steering away from buying the little trinkets. Yeah, they're cute, but I just feel like they make your space look very cluttered. Like, it can happen very quickly, and buying bigger, stately pieces like this, I feel they look more expensive and they make your house feel more expensive as well. I eventually want to have like a designated space for all the vessels I collect. Like, how dope would it be to walk into somebody's house and it's like a gallery, like an art gallery, but for vessels, right when you walk in on some shelves? I just think that'll be so bomb. So yeah, vessels and pots are foolproof. You can leave them empty. You can put floral stems or branches in them. You can display them on pedestals, on console tables, and you can even turn these into lamps, like if you know how to drill a hole without breaking it. Or you can even like stick an existing lamp and put one of those battery rechargeable light bulbs in it and turn it into a lamp. So very versatile, couldn't pass it up. So with that last vessel, I also got his cousin, which is this one. Usually if I love something and it comes in a set, I'm gonna get it. Case in point. This one has way more of that, ooh, my light, that's a little bit better. This one has way more of that light, peachy, tannish tone, but I love it so much. This one was only $29.99, and these are by Drexel Heritage. I will link the style numbers down below. By the way, the style numbers that I leave down below, they're not linked to a website or anything. They're the style numbers that come on the Home Goods tag. So if you want to call your local Home Goods to see if they have it, it's an easy way to narrow it down. But anyway, like I said, I got this one. I couldn't pass it up. Like I said, the texture is just amazing. You can even see the little cracks in it. I will give you a close-up on the side because y'all know how my light be hating sometimes. And I know it seems like I have been shopping a lot, because I have been shopping a lot, but I'm actually elevating pieces that I already have. So in my bookcase that I have in my living areas, the vase, the vases that are in there are more modern and streamlined and white, and I kind of want to add a rustic, warm element to them. So I really am just, you know, building up my inventory whenever I want to do a refresh. So yeah, I just love, y'all, the little spikes on this, it just gets me. And Brutalist vases like this go for like thousands online. So even if it's not the color that you, you know, that you don't want, like I always tell you guys, you can always change that. It's literally paint and baking soda and you're in the game. So yeah, that's that one. Now this next pot actually looks like the first one, but there's a bit of a twist. So I've been really into glazed pottery. Pottery Barn has some pieces that I have been eyeing, but those prices, I can't.
No sir, not me.
So when I saw this at Home Goods for $39.99, I had to get him. Like I said, he's glazed. He has that little Brutalist element with the spikes and it's still a little rough. I did plan on putting this in my bedroom because as you can see, I have this like mocha color going on and this has like that brown mocha here on the top and on the bottom. And it's like peeking through on the little spikes or the bumps here on the body. This is a great example of what I like to call refined rustic because you get the rustic element with the top because this is like matte and kind of raw. And this is more refined because of the glaze. So yeah, I'm gonna see where it fits best in my room. I'm thinking on my console table, but you guys would just have to stay tuned because I am going to be refreshing my bedroom. You know, fall is coming and I don't do seasonal decor, but usually I'll just do little things like switch out the pillows or the wall art or the decorative pieces I have around in here to make it feel more like fall. So hit that subscribe button so you don't miss it. I also need to figure out if I want to add stems or not to this in here because I don't have any life or any faux life here in my bedroom in regards to plants. So you guys let me know what you think. I think it'll look really cute with some branches coming out of it, but I'm not sure. So yeah, comment down below. So this next piece I'm so excited about is this chubby little jug and I just had to get it. It really reminds me of the pot I saw in Gwyneth Paltrow's entryway. She had like a little stem in it. It was so cute, so I had to get him. This was only $39.99 at Home Goods and he has the perfect amount of distressing. Like it's not over distressed or underwhelmingly distressed. It's perfect. A little bit of smudging in it, but not too much where it's like, oh my gosh, that looks really old. I just love the way it looks. Like it's faded and meshed very, very well. There are some cool and warm tones in this, and it's not overly stated but not underwhelming either. Like I said before, like it's perfect. I love it so much. I love the little handle. I love its shape. It's just amazing to me. Like I told you guys before, if you want to add a little bit of life to them, add a little branch, some little leaves in this, and it changes the whole game. It just completely transforms a space. This was actually handcrafted in the Philippines. Very cool. So it's going to create a well-traveled home, even if you oh my gosh, excuse me. Even if you haven't been to the country that it's been made in, which I feel like that's actually really cool though, to visit a country and bring something back from there. But sometimes it's not practical because how are you gonna fit it in your suitcase? Do I wanna pay for shipping from another country to my country? 9 times out of 10, I don't. So this is a good alternative and yeah, love this. This is probably one of my favorite ones that I have in my home. Okay guys, that is it for me today. Thank you so much for tuning in and spending some time with me. Like always, the style numbers for these pieces will be down below in the description box to make it easier for you to locate them in your nearest location. To make it easier to find in your local, oh my gosh. To make it easier for you guys to find in your local Home Goods location, don't forget to like, comment, and share. Hit that subscribe button and notification bell if you haven't. Take care of yourselves, those around you, and your mental health. And I will see you guys in my next video. But until then, peace out.